Hello everyone, this is Alex. In this video, I am going to explain you some of the important questions from the pediatrics subject, so which will be useful for your NASET, I mean AIIMS exam and NEET PG, ESIC, JIPMER PGI, all the government exams. Okay, without wasting much time, I am going to explain some of the questions. So your first question for today is, what is the range of MUAC for malnutrition? What is the range of MUAC? MUAC stands for mid upper arm circumference. Mid upper arm circumference. So, what is the range of MUAC for malnutrition? So, your options are less than 12.5 centimeters, B less than 11.5 centimeters, option C less than 13.5 centimeters, option D 14.5 centimeters. So we are discussing here mid upper arm circumference related to malnutrition means SAM. Okay, SAM stands for severe acute malnutrition. Okay, students, remember SAM stands for severe acute malnutrition. Okay, previously this was called as a PEM, protein energy malnutrition. What is this? Protein energy malnutrition. But nowadays it is called as a SAM, severe acute malnutrition. So according to the WHO definition for SAM, okay, definition for SAM is mainly three things. What was that? So mid upper arm circumference less than 11.5 centimeters is one of the point for severe acute malnutrition, and weight for height is less than minus 3 standard deviations. And third one is bilateral pitting edema in the legs. Okay, so if these three things are present, that is considered as a SAM, severe acute malnutrition. Okay, so now what we are discussing, what is the range of MUAC for malnutrition? Your answer is right, B. Okay, so less than 11.5 centimeters of mid upper arm circumference is equal to malnutrition or severe acute malnutrition. How you will calculate this mid upper arm circumference? From the shoulder to the elbow, okay, you will measure and make a center point here. Okay, so there acromion process to the allocranium process. Okay, center point you will mark it, and here you will measure with a separate tape called that is Shakir tape. Okay, Shakir tape. There is a tape called to measure the MUAC, that is called Shakir tape. On this tape, so there is a measurements will be there, like 10, 10.5, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, like this will be there. Suppose your mid upper arm circumference is less than 11.5, okay, less than 11.5, then your severe acute malnutrition. Okay, 11.5 to 12.5 is my moderate. Okay, so if it is above 13, mild, okay, normal. Okay, this is our rating for calculating the severe acute malnutrition by using Shaki tape. What will measure mid upper arm circumference? Okay, in the next question, your next question, premature babies have a more chances of hypothermia because of all the following except, okay, your options are cold environment, B less developed epidermis, C less brown fat and D small body surface area in comparison of weight. Okay, what is your question? Premature babies have more chances of hypothermia. Yes. So because of all the following, except we have to find out except. Okay, it means out of four options you will have three right answers. You need to eliminate or you need to find out what was the wrong option related to hypothermia. Okay, so in a premature babies, hypothermia is very common, very common. Okay, so why this hypothermia is taking place, why, how to maintain the temperature in premature babies, means there is a NST, means non-shivering thermogenesis. Generally in adults we will shiver, okay, for generating the heat in the body. By this non-shivering thermogenesis, okay, in the babies, premature babies or babies, okay, there is a heat production will takes place in the babies. In this process, what how heat will develop? By breakdown of the brown fat. Okay, breakdown of the brown fat. Brown fat breakdown. Breakdown leads to thermogenesis. Thermogenesis means heat production. Heat production. Okay, but even premature babies have chances of hypothermia because of all. So we are finding out the causes of hypothermia. Okay, cold environment is also obviously, cold environment related to hypothermia. Less developed epidermis, definitely. If there is a less developed epidermis, so heat loss will be there. Okay, so leads to hypothermia. Okay, less brown fat also one of the cause. So fourth option is small body surface area in comparison of weight. So this is a, your answer is this one. Because in a premature babies, large body surface area will be there. Surface compared to the age. Okay. So large body surface, mostly head will be large. Okay. Head will be large. So more heat loss from the head will take place. Okay. Not a small body surface area. Okay. This is your answer. And next question. Which of the following is the most common cause of UTI in children? Okay, which of the following is the most common cause of UTI in children? So your options are E. coli, Proteus, Staphylococcus aureus and Pneumococcus. So this is a right answer and it is a big topic also for discussing UTI in children. So your answer is E. coli. Okay, E. coli is the most common cause of UTI in the children's. Okay. Next, fourth question, all indicators are age dependent except, okay, all indicators are age dependent, the indicators which depends on age, okay, but one of the indicator from your options is independent, okay, you need to find out the independent indicator, okay, not depending on the age, okay, your options are chest circumference, option B, BMI, option C, weight for height, option D, MUSC, mid upper arm circumference. Okay, so just read the question once again. All indicators are age dependent, okay, except, okay, only one indicator is not a dependent on age. So chest circumference obviously depends on the age, okay, based by the age, so chest circumference also increase, age increase, chest circumference also increase. BMI same, based on age, okay, BMI also increase. Weight for height definitely increase, but mid upper arm circumference is a independent indicator. Okay, so your answer is D. Why this independent mid upper arm circumference independent indicator? So this mid upper arm circumference from the 6 months to the 5 years. Okay. So this mid upper arm circumference will not change. okay, most probably the same, okay, will be there from the 6 months to the 5 years. So it is not changing with the age, okay, not changing with the age. So that's why, so this is a independent indicator. So your option is, your answer is mid upper arm circumference. And next question, exclusive breastfeeding should be up to which age? Exclusive breastfeeding should be up to which age? So this is a frequently asked question, okay, related to breastfeeding. You will get so many questions, okay. So frequently asked question, and it is very easy topic. Most of the times I also explained in my videos, okay. Exclusive breastfeeding up to 6 months, okay. So this is a straight question, okay. Exclusive breastfeeding should be up to 6 months you have to give. So what is exclusive breeding? So without breastfeeding, you should not, only breastfeeding should be give to the baby up to 6 months of age, okay. Except in a cases of medically advisable, okay. Otherwise, only breastfeeding. Even in a hot summer also, breastfeeding is only sufficient up to the 6 months of age. Okay, after six months, you can start the complementary feeding, okay, or weaning, okay. Okay, that's all. Next question. Choice of fluid in children with moderate dehydration. Okay, choice of fluid in children with moderate dehydration. Your options are dextrose 5%, option B dextrose 10%, option C normal saline, and option D Ringer lactate. Okay, what we are discussing, the topic is dehydration. Okay, here you can divide mild dehydration, moderate and severe dehydration. Okay, in mild, moderate, severe dehydrations, okay, mild dehydration you can manage at home level only, okay, you can manage at home level, okay, by giving the ORS or a zinc, okay. But in a moderate dehydration you can give ORS or RL, Ringer lactate, okay. RL, how much you can give? RL at 75 ml per kg, okay, up to 5 to 6 hours, okay, 5 to 6 hours you can give, okay. You need a hospitalization or at least OP basis, okay, moderate dehydration. But coming to the severe dehydration, the only choice is RL, okay, RL, Ringer lactate, at 100 ml per kg, okay, you have to give, okay. So what are the severe dehydration manifestations or signs and symptoms mainly, okay. That is also frequently asked question sometimes in children's, they will ask you some signs and symptoms related to dehydration, and they will ask what it relates to. Okay, sunken eyeballs is one of the manifestation, and decreased urine output, and skin turgor also decreased skin turgor. Okay, and fontanelles depressed also, refuse to feeding, okay. So that is also one. So these are the related to severe dehydration, or you can related to moderate also, okay. In moderate, mainly the symptom is eagerly drink to water or fluid. Okay, so that is. So now coming to the question, what is the choice of fluid in moderate dehydration? I told you here mild, moderate, severe. Okay, in moderate dehydration, directly ORS or RL. Here your option is RL. Okay, so if you see RL related to Ringer lactate related to dehydration, when you will give in a rehydration situation, dehydration or in a diarrhea situations, or a fluid of choice for burns also. Okay, for giving rehydration, so RL is very very useful. Okay, so RL is useful. And what is the why we'll use this normal saline? Mainly will in case of hypovolemia cases, hypovolemia or hypovolemic shock. Okay, D10 hypoglycemic state, hypoglycemic condition. Okay, so these are the some of the examples for these fluids also. Okay, so your option is, your answer is RL. Okay, and next, question, length of a child doubles by, this is also very very important from the neonatology. So neonatology, so length of a baby doubles by, or a weight of the baby doubles or triples by. Okay, that is also important. So your options are 2 years, 3 years, 4 years and 5 years. Okay, so length of the baby doubles by option A 2 years, and option B 3 years, option C 4 years, and option D 5 years. Okay, what is the normal length at birth? Okay, 48 to 50 centimeters is the normal length. Okay, at birth, and it is doubles by,4 years. Okay, 4 years. So it means doubles means 100 centimeters. Okay, and triples by, 12 years. Okay, it means 150 centimeters. Okay, at normal length of the baby at birth 50 centimeters, by 4 years it is doubled to 100 centimeter, by 12 years it will be tripled. Okay, so your answer is length of a child doubles by how many years? Okay, so 4 years is the correct answer. Okay, option C is the correct answer. And next, which size of suction catheter is used in child? Okay, which size of suction catheter is used in child? Your options are 10 French, 8 French, 12 French and 14 French. Okay, so based on the NRP program, okay, neonatal resuscitation protocol. Okay, NRP stands for neonatal resuscitation protocol. Okay, based on the neonatal resuscitation program, usually we will use 6 to 8 French, 6 to 8 French. Okay, 6 to 8 French suction catheter we will use in a children's. Okay, so your option is, so 8 is the correct answer. 8 French is the correct answer. Okay, and one more question they may ask you related to suction. So what is the suction pressure? Okay, what is the suction pressure? Suction pressure for using in children, 80 millimeter of mercury or 100 centimeter of water, H2O. Okay, this is also one of the important. Okay, what is the suction pressure? 80 millimeter of mercury or 100 centimeters of water is the your answer. So the next question is complementary feeding start set. Complementary feeding start set. Complementary feeding means, so complementary feeding start set options are 3 months, 6 months, 9 months and 12 months. Okay, I told you already in the previous question in the breastfeeding topic. So we will give exclusive exclusive breastfeeding up to 6 months of age. 6 months of age. Okay. After that, you can start the complementary feeding. Okay. Complementary feeding means like giving dalia, porridge. Okay. Or some smashed foods. Okay. Etc. Okay. All some semi-solid foods you can give. Okay, by using Katori chamach methods, etc. Okay. So complementary feeding starts at 6 months. Complementary feeding, or you can say weaning also. Okay. So that is your answer. Okay. And next question: a child reported in emergency with acute bronchospasm. And has a history of bee sting. Okay, what is the most preferred route of adrenaline administration? Your answers are, your options are intraosseous, option B intramuscular, option C subcutaneous, option D intratracheal. Okay, I am repeating the question again. A child reported in emergency department with acute bronchospasm and has a history of bee sting. Okay, what is the most preferred route of giving adrenaline? Okay, so we need to find out the adrenaline administration. So what is this case? It is a case of bee sting. Okay, case of bee sting. Okay, bee sting bite. In this case, what is happening? What happened already? Acute bronchospasm. So why it happened? It is related to anaphylactic reaction. In this case, definitely we will give an injection called adrenaline is a first drug of choice. So what is the route? Okay, what is the route of administration? Usually, okay, see, intraosseous we will not give. Okay, intramuscular also definitely we will not give. So between the subcutaneous and intratracheal, usually adrenaline we can give through the intratracheal. But subcutaneous route administration gives a rapid action in this case. Okay, why? Already there is a bronchospasm. Okay, you are in this situation. If you want to give intratracheal, you need to intubate the case. Then if you giving this adrenaline, it takes a long time. But if you give adrenaline through subcutaneous, it will act rapidly. So your answer is subcutaneous is correct in this situation. Okay. Next question. What is the chest compression and ventilation ratio in neonatal resuscitation? What is the chest compression and ventilation ratio in neonatal resuscitation? Your options are A 3:1, B 4:1, C 15:2, D 30:2. Okay. Obviously, as per the latest researches or guidelines, 3:1 is the right answer. Okay, three compressions and one bag and mask ventilation. Okay, three compressions and one bag and mask ventilation. Three compression, one bag and mask ventilation. 15:2 is in BLS. Okay, so compared to 15:2 in children's or neonates, that is a different scenario. Compared to this, 3:1 is giving a more probability to keep alive the patient. Okay, so 3:1 is the best answer out of all these four options. So for giving neonatal resuscitation, again, there is a chance for asking questions. How you will give the CPR technique? Okay, one is thumb technique, or a two finger technique also there. Okay, thumb technique, like this, we will hold a baby like this and we will compress with the thumbs, and two fingers means only we will press this, use these two fingers and press the chest. Okay, so how we will give 1 2 3 1 ventilation, bag and mask ventilation. I am repeating, bag and mask, not mouth to mouth. Okay, bag and mask ventilation. 1 2 3 One ventilation. So that is your answer in a neonatal resuscitation. Best ratio is 3:1. And next question is, a baby admitted in hospital with the complaint of foreign body aspiration, the nurse will do. Your options are 5 back slaps, 5 chest thrusts, and option B, 2 back slaps, 2 chest thrusts, option C, Heimlich maneuver, option D, CPR. Okay, here in this case, okay, they're given a baby admitted in hospital. So best option to relieve the foreign body aspiration is Heimlich maneuver, by holding the baby or patient from the backside and giving a chest compressions like this. Okay, so back slaps, chest thrusts in a different scenario. So Heimlich maneuver is the best answer to removing the body foreign body aspiration or removing the choking. Okay. Next question, identify the correct method of inserting catheter in a neonate. Okay, identify the correct method in a neonate inserting catheter. Your options, 12 French is appropriate size for catheterization in neonate. That is not a correct one, because usually sometimes you may use 8 or 10 French also. Okay, it depends on the situation or age. Okay, no requirement of gel. That is also wrong, because we have to use jelly, okay, at least some jelly, and inflate the balloon after insertion of entire catheter. This is right. And inflate the balloon when urine seen, no matter location of the catheter. No, this is also wrong. We have to see the location. So suppose this is a penis, okay, so you inserted a catheter and this is a bladder. Okay, suppose if you inserted up to here, then also urine will come sometimes, but you have to check the location after completely insertion of the Foley's catheter, then start giving by using the 5 ml or 10 ml syringe. Okay, give the in case of baby, no, so use 5 ml, flush it, okay, and then bulb will be blown. So then you check the patency, whether it is there in a correct site or not. Okay, then only that is a correct insertion of catheter. Okay, that is the correct procedure. So your option is, your answer is C is the correct. Okay, next, weight of infant is quadruple by. In the previous questions we discussed about related to length. Okay, length doubles by 4 years, triples by 12 years. Okay, but here we are discussing of weight of infant is quadruple, means four times. Okay, what is your option? 1 year, 2 year, 3 year, 4 years. Okay, then we have to discuss about normal birth weight. What is the normal birth? Usually 2.5 to 3 or 3.5 kgs is the normal birth weight of Indian. Okay, so it will be, normal birth weight is a 2.5 and 3, so it will be doubled by 5 months, triple by 1 year, and quadruple by 2 years. Okay, doubles, triples, and quadruple by 2 years. Okay, it means suppose 2.5, you imagine here, double means 5 kgs, triple, okay, 10 kgs, here it will be 12.5. No, triple, 7.5 and 10 kgs. Okay, so your answer is 2 years. 2 years is the correct answer. Okay, triple, quadruple by 2 years. Okay, signs of dehydration in children. Signs of dehydration in children, we already discussed in the first question itself. Dehydration, types of dehydration, okay, mild, moderate, and severe. And in that I told you some of the signs and symptoms also. Signs of dehydration in children: sunken eye, irritability, cry, all of the above. So definitely this sunken eye will be present in severe type of dehydration, irritability also present in severe dehydration, and mild dehydration, moderate dehydration, cry also will be there. So it means your answer is all of the above. So sunken eye, irritability, cry will be there in the dehydration. So next question, a child was suffering from a common cold. Child was suffering from a common cold. After 2 weeks, he started having pain in the ear. Okay, what could be the probable diagnosis? Common cold, after 2 weeks, started a pain in the ear. Okay, what could be the probable diagnosis? Sinusitis, option B, otitis media, option C, tonsillitis. Straight answer. So, related to ear is only otitis media. Sinusitis is different, tonsillitis is different. So, your answer is option B, otitis media is the diagnosis. Okay. Next question. Low birth weight baby is one with weight. Okay. We are discussing about low birth weight, LBW, low birth weight. Okay. You need to know what is the normal birth weight. Okay. What is a low birth weight and what is very low birth weight? What is extreme low birth weight? Okay, so normal birth weight, I told you already 2.5 to 3.5 kgs. Okay, and low birth weight, it means less than 2.5 kgs. Very low birth weight, less than 2 kgs. And extremely low birth weight, less than 1 kg. Okay, less than 1 kg. Okay, very low birth weight, you can say up less than 1.5 kg or less than 1 kg. Okay, so low birth weight is one weight. Weight is your answers. I told you 2.5 to 3.5 LBW, less than 2.5 kgs. Very low birth weight, less than 1.5 kg. Extremely low birth, less than 1.1 kg, less than 1 kg. Okay. So your options are 2500 grams means 2.5 kgs, 1800 grams, 2.9 kgs, 3.5 kgs. So right answer is low birth weight is 1800 grams. Okay, 1800 grams means obviously it is less than 2.5 kgs. So it is coming under low birth weight category. So that is your answer. Normal, next question, normal pulse rate in newborn. Normal pulse rate. So in neonatology, if you read normal values like height, weight, and when it will be double, triple, okay, and vitals also, normal vitals also, definitely you will get 2 to 3 questions. Okay, in a normal values of neonatology. Okay, that is the thing. And here, normal pulse rate in newborn, your options are 8200 beats per minute, option B, 120 to 160 beats per minute, option C, 140 to 160 beats per minute, option D, 80 to 160 beats per minute. If you know the answers, please try to type in the comment box. Okay, when I am reading, try to comment in the comment box. Okay, that is a good thing. So normal newborn pulse rate is between the 120 to 160 is a correct answer. You can say 140 to 160 also, but range should be correct. Okay, so 120 to 160 beats per minute is the normal pulse rate. Okay, you read about normal respiratory rate, okay, normal BP, okay, and temperature, all these things also. Okay, and next question. Septic shock in child is a type of which type of shock? Answers, your options are distributive shock, hypovolemic shock, cardiogenic shock, obstetric shock. Okay, your options are distributive shock, hypovolemic shock, cardiogenic shock. Okay, so in this shock, sometimes they may ask you, what is the commonest cause of shock? What is the commonest type of shock in a child, they may ask you. So, for most common type of shock is hypovolemic shock. Most common cause. Okay. Most common type of shock. Most common type of shock is hypovolemic shock. Okay. Second most common type is septic shock, or you can say distributive shock. Okay, and third most common is cardiogenic shock. So septic shock also called as a distributive shock. Okay, so septic shock in a child is a type of distributive shock. Okay, that is the answer. Septic shock related to distributive shock. Hypovolemic is different, cardiogenic is different, and obstetric is different. So sometimes they may ask you, what is the most common type of shock? That answer is hypovolemic. Second most common type of cause is shock is septic. Third, cardiogenic. Okay, next question. A 3-year-old child was presented with acute respiratory infection. Okay, acute respiratory infection. Nurse should avoid. Okay, your options: mouth and nose suctioning, providing position to side lying, and O2 inhalation. Okay, 3-year-old. What we have to do? What is the condition? Acute respiratory infection. Okay, ARI. So acute respiratory infection, in this situation, what nurse should avoid? So O2 inhalation definitely you have to give, because related to ARI, oxygen should be given, and providing position to side lying or means head up position or a Fowler's position, you can say Fowler position. Okay, prominent position, you can say. So this position, providing position is also important. So mouth and nose suction is not required. So this is the answer. What should avoid? Mouth and nose suctioning should be avoided, because there is no secretions and not that much required. Okay, so you're out of this option. That is your option. That is your answer. And what is the dose of injection adrenaline during the infant cardiac arrest? Dose of injection adrenaline during infant cardiac arrest. Your options are 0.1 ml per kg IV. Okay, that means 1 is to 10,000 dilution. And your option B, 0.5 ml per kg IM, 1 is to 1000 dilution. Option C, 1 ml per kg IV, 1 is to 10,000. Okay, so that is your options. Dose of adrenaline during the infant cardiac arrest. Usually, 1 ampoule of adrenaline is available in 1 is to 1000 dilution. Okay, 1 is to 1000 dilution. Okay, so you will make it into 1 is to 10,000 dilution. 10,000 dilution. How you will make? Will take 1 ml. Of NS, 1 ml of adrenaline, 1 ml of NS, 1 ml, okay, adrenaline in a 9 ml of NS. Okay, so it became 1 is to 10,000 dilution. Okay, so how much we will give in a new infant cardiac arrest? 0.1 ml per kg. IV only we will give 0.1 ml. From this 0.1 ml per kg IV, it means 1 is to 10,000 dilution we will give. Okay, so that is, so your option, your answer is 0.1 ml per kg IV, 1 ml. Okay, your answer is A. So that's all for today. If you like my content, please do like, share, subscribe. Okay. And if you have any doubts also, please try to write in the comment box. Or if any corrections also, try to write in the comment box. Okay. Or if you want any extra content, extra explanation, please do mention in the comments. Okay. Thanks for today. In the next video, I will come up with another subject questions. Thank you so much, guys.